the compact crossover segment has been growing by leaps and bounds. The vehicle behind me, the Chevy Equinox, is one of the better vehicles in the segment. However, it's not on too many people's shopping lists, so we're going to take a quick look at it and tell you why it should be on yours. Like most vehicles in the segment, the Equinox is offered with two engine options. The base engine is a 2.4-liter four-cylinder Ecotec engine that produces 184 horsepower. Now, this is an upgraded engine. It's a 3-liter direct injection V6 producing 262 horsepower. The base LS model is only available with the four-cylinder engine. However, the 1LT, 2LT, and top-of-the-line LTZ are available with either engine. One of the more innovative features of the Chevy Equinox is the second row. It actually slides. As you can see, it's got plenty of seat travel, so if you have a lot of cargo in the back and maybe don't need the room, you can slide it forward. If you've got passengers, don't have a lot of cargo back there, slide it all the way back. As you can see, at 6'1", I fit quite comfortably. Speaking of seat travel, Chevy offers more seat travel than any other vehicle in the segment. In fact, it's the only crossover that I have to put the seat not all the way back. As you can see, I can barely reach the pedal. I love it. Chevy's infotainment system is so advanced, you really think you're in a luxury car. In fact, you not only have AM, FM, and XM, which you see in many vehicles, even in this segment, it's even got Pandora and Stitcher. And what's this, a CD? All Equinox models are equipped with a 6-speed automatic transmission. And this is the second generation GM 6-speed automatic. And it's really quite lovely. It shifts quickly, it's very responsive, and it gets good fuel economy. About 32 on the highway and 22 in the city. One of my complaints about the Equinox is that the engine is a little whiny. All right, listen to this. Kind of noisy, especially when you look at the segment. And speaking of the segment, there's some real heavyweights. For example, the Toyota RAV4 and Honda CR-V, by far the clear leaders. But you have vehicles like the Ford Escape that has just been redesigned, and it's a pretty impressive vehicle. And Mazda, believe it or not, has just entered the segment with a CX-5, and it gets the best fuel economy of not only any traditional crossover, but any hybrid crossover in that segment. So that's a vehicle you should look at. But we do like the Equinox. Starting price is around $24,000 for a base front-wheel drive four-cylinder, and it can go up as high as $34,000 for a fully loaded LTZ with all-wheel drive and six-cylinder. So go visit your Chevy dealer, but I would recommend visiting all the others. It's a great segment. Everyone's got some really good vehicles to offer.